So now we will see the circular motion or rotation of any object in a vertical plane. Vertical plane means rotation in vertical plane means like this, rotation in this. If we tie a stone along with a string and other end in our finger, then if we rotate in this direction, this is called vertical plane. But if we rotate like this, takes place in this plane, this is called horizontal plane. Okay, so now we will find out the expressions of the velocity and the tension of the string in this. So suppose a stone or any object of mass m, okay, is rotating, okay, is rotating in this vertical plane, vertically in anti-clockwise direction. Here in this anti-clockwise direction, it may be in clockwise direction. Case, okay, result will be the same. So in these cases, when the stone is at the bottom, so when we will rotate it in the vertical plane, so when it will reach at the top, that is at point B, so it is just like its velocity will decrease slightly, and we may assume its tension will slightly loosen. This means the string will slightly loosen, so tension is slightly decreases also. Again, when it will reach from top to bottom, then again its velocity will increase, tension will also increase. It means in the case the tension of the string is just like stout, very tight. So in this case we can see at the bottom velocity is maximum, at the bottom velocity increases, and at the top velocity decreases. So it means velocity is keep changing, because in this case since velocity is increasing at the bottom and decreasing at the top, so the tension of the string will not be same. Here it will be tight and here it will be slightly loose. So in this case the speed of the object will not uniform. So we cannot say this is uniform circular motion, because depending on our hand, isn't it? Now centripetal force acts in the along the center, that is radially inward direction. Weight of the object is acting in the downward direction, as well as centripetal force, centrifugal force is acting, okay, radially outward direction. So now in this diagram we will assume two points, point A at the bottom and B at the top. So considering the velocity, okay, considering the motion of the stone at point A, now tension is acting in the upward direction and weight is in the downward direction. Since resultantly the object is reaching in the upward direction, so we can say the resultant force is T1 minus mg. So this is the resultant force, and this force is responsible for providing necessary centripetal force, because since the object is moving in circular path, so that's why this will provide, this resultant net force provides this necessary centripetal force, that is m b1 square by r, assuming b1 is the velocity of the stone at point A, giving then the equation 1. Now at point B, when it will reach point B, suppose the now the velocity is v2, now velocity cannot be same, because velocity will slightly decrease. So now tension is also t2, since tension will also not same, it will slightly decrease also. So here at point B, tension t2 is acting in this direction towards the central, okay, weight is also in the same direction of t2. So now here t2 plus mg, since both are acting along the same direction, so this is the net force which supplies the necessary centripetal force at point B, that is m v2 square by r. V2 is the velocity of the stone or the object at point B, okay, giving, okay, the equation 2. Now assuming that, now assume at point B, if the tension is t2 is equal to 0 momentarily, okay, now here v2 will not be 0, because it is not just like the vertical throw of any object along gravity, okay, against gravity, that it will, after reaching maximum height, momentarily it will stop and then down, since it is taking place in circular path, so it gradually decrease, but velocity cannot be 0, it will be slight, okay, it will be minimum, isn't it, but it cannot be 0, since it is not attaining, it is not the vertical height, isn't it, it is not attaining the vertical height and then comes downward, that is, it is taking place in a circular path. So it will decrease, and again after coming, okay, again reaching the bottom point. So assuming if the tension, if the string becomes very loose, so in that case, assuming if t2 is equal to 0, so putting the value of t2 is equal to 0 in equation 2, we get mg is equal to mv2 square by r, isn't it? Now in this case, we are going to find out what will be the maximum velocity at B, isn't it? It means what will be the maximum velocity, okay, to maintain this circular motion, isn't it? Below that, the tension will be extremely slackened, loose, and then it will move, okay, it will fall in the downward direction, okay. So if you don't want to let that happen, what will be the maximum velocity? So that it can maintain its minimum circular motion. Clear, understood? So in the case, we assume if T2 is equal to 0, so mm cross, so V2 square, G is equal to V2 square, calculating this, we get V2 square is equal to GR, so V2 maximum, it is also called critical velocity, clear, at the top, where at the top, mind it, we are finding the maximum velocity, okay, the maximum, okay, velocity of the object below which, okay, to maintain the circular motion, so it is root over GR. So we can say now, if the velocity of the stone or the object is less than this, in that case, the string will be extremely loose, tension, okay, extremely loose, and in that case, the body will fall. The body will fall down. Clear? We have assumed it is equal to 0. This is the maximum velocity at point B. If velocity drops down this value, the body will fall down. So this is the critical velocity at point B, that is at the top, at point top. So in this condition, when the body will keep maintaining its circular motion, isn't it? With the maximum velocity, it will execute. With less velocity, it also can maintain circular motion. So this is the, okay, velocity to maintain the circular motion. Now, at that condition, so that is also velocity of the object at the point, at the bottom point. Now we will find out the minimum velocity at point A for this. Clear? That is, to maintain this critical velocity. To maintain this critical velocity or to maintain the circular motion, what will be the minimum velocity at point A, that is at the bottom. Clear? So now, to find out that, since the body is moving from bottom to top, top to bottom, so it means from bottom to top, isn't it? So at the bottom, its velocity is maximum, increases, and while reaching at the top, it decreases velocity. So in both the cases, you can see it, here it acquires some energy, and here it loses some energy. Isn't it? Since velocity decreases, since here velocity increases, so its energy is maximum, and while reaching at B, its velocity decreases, so its energy, it loses some energy. But where does this energy go away? You can see, now it reaches from point A to B, it means it is attending, it is traversing some vertical height, which is nothing but its diameter. So it is nothing but it is stored at the point B as gravitational potential energy. Because next it will have to come down to bottom. With that energy, it is again coming. Energy loses from A to B is again gaining from B to A. Law of conservation of energy. So whatever energy loses from the journey from A to B, it will grab stored air as a gravitational potential energy. So we may write that the lose in kinetic energy, that is losing half A V1 square minus half A V2 square. Why minus? Since velocity is decreasing, as I said. That is mgh, stored as a gravitational potential energy. What is the h? H is the vertical height, since radius is r, isn't it? Here, radius is r, at the radius of this path, here the radius of this vertical path is, we may assume this is r. So, that is mg into twice r, clear? So now calculating, cancelling m from each other, half m v1 square is equal to, okay, twice mgr plus, half m v2 square, so v1 square, mm cross, multiplying 2 into 2, 4 gr plus 2 into half means 1 gr, that is 5 gr. So this is v1 minimum is equal to root over 5 gr. So the critical velocity to maintain the circular motion at the top of this plane is root over gr. At such condition, at this condition, point vc is or v2 max is root over gr, the velocity at the bottom point is root over 5 gr. Clear? Now we will find out the minimum tension at point A. Now we can easily get the value of tension at point A from equation 1. Okay, T1 equals to mg plus m v1 square. By substituting the value of v1 square, we have already got the value of v1 minimum. So mg plus m by r into putting the value of v1 minimum cross cancel. So mg plus m into 56 mg means T1 minimum equals to 6 into weight of the body. So the required tension, minimum tension at point A in such case is 6 times the weight of the body. Clear? Where is the expression? Based on this, now we will discuss a very interesting topic, that is, we may have seen, okay, so many times, that is, if we rotate, if we take a bucket of water, not full, okay, bucket of water, and if we rotate fast in the vertical plane, even when the bucket is at the top, the water doesn't fall down, isn't it? What is the reason? What will be the condition? Let's see. Same cases, isn't it? Suppose a bucket not full with water, slightly filled, okay, half or okay, not full of full bucket of water. If you rotate in the vertical plane, after reaching at the top, the water doesn't fall down. But if the velocity, but if we move very slowly, it falls down. So here in this case, centripetal force acts on the bucket, since, isn't it, centripetal force acts on the bucket, but here the reactionary force, the centrifugal force acts in the radial outward direction, it means on the water, mind it, bucket full with water, moving in the circular path, here centripetal force is acting on the bucket, pulling, isn't it, but the centripetal force acts on the, that is, the outward direction, it is acting on the water, and its weight acts in the downward direction, that is mg. Suppose the radius of the path is r. Clear? M is the mass of bucket plus water, isn't it? So in this case, the condition for water not to falling down is very easy, isn't it? Since reactionary force, since water along with bucket faces in the downward direction, a reactionary force, that is centrifugal force, acts in the upward direction. So it's very clear the condition for not falling down of water, isn't that the reactionary force has to be greater than the weight of the bucket plus water, isn't it? If bucket plus, or the weight of the bucket plus water is greater than centrifugal force, or centrifugal force is less than the weight of the bucket plus water, it will easily fall down. So here centrifugal force, we all know that magnitude is same as centripetal force, mv square by r. So we may write centrifugal c, okay, or we can write fc. Centrifugal FCA, clear? So if centrifugal greater than equals to mg, very easy, reaction equals to hold, either greater than or equal to, cannot be less than greater than equal to mg. So putting the value of centrifugal force, mg square by r, greater than equals to mg, and then for a same condition, v square is equal to gr, because it is at the top, where v is the velocity of the bucket at the top position, okay, at the top. So you can see v maximum equals to greater than equal to root over gr, same. But as I said, this experiment is not possible by taking a full of a pool with water, okay, the bucket full with water. Why? Now if you find out the tension at the top, isn't it, at the bottom, when it will reach at the, when it will move at the down, the tension is very easy, 6 mg, it means the tension on our hand at the bottom will be 6 times of the weight of the bucket plus water, which is very, very difficult, isn't it? You know, we may assume the weight of a bucket plus water here. Now, if it is 6 times, if it increases 6 times, you may assume. So, that's why it is difficult, very difficult in this case, okay, to perform this experiment by taking a bucket full of water. It can be performed by taking a half bucket of water, okay. So, this is the expression. Okay.